Now let's take our wave equations and analyze how they are actually going to be used. If we have a simple wave, let's analyze a wave that has a planar wave front. We call this a plane wave. It means that everything along this particular plane is absolutely equal. The magnitude's equal and the phase is equal. And then as it propagates, the magnitude is equal and the phase is equal on this plane. And finally, the magnitude is equal and the phase is equal on this plane. This wave is propagating in this positive direction, and these planes would extend in infinite extents. In this case, we could write a simple equation that would say the electric field as a function of, let's say, z. The electric field as a function of z is going to have a positive going term. There's going to be part of the electric field going this way. And just in case we hit something, we might also have an electric field going in the negative direction. We can write this the same way we did when we were doing the transmission line equations, where we have e to the minus j gamma z plus e zero minus e to the plus j gamma z. It also can be written this way, e zero plus e to the minus alpha z e to the minus j beta z plus e zero minus e to the plus alpha z e to the plus j beta z. So this gives us a forward traveling wave and a backward traveling wave. Similar equations can be written for the magnetic field. Now, how do we go from electric field to magnetic field? This is how it's done. Right-hand rule, just like we had before. The direction of propagation is going to be my thumb. I'm going to write D on that. The electric field is my first finger. I'm going to write E. And my third finger is the magnetic field, H. Let's write those. And the equation that we will have is that E cross H is equal to the direction of propagation. So I can do it one of several ways. The easiest way, I think, is to put my fingers in the direction of the electric field and cross them towards the magnetic field. So E cross H gives me direction of propagation. So in this case, E cross H would give me direction of Z propagation. The other way that I can do it is holding my hand as the three corners of a square. I have E cross H is equal to the direction of propagation. So I just spread them out like this. E cross H is the direction of propagation. So if I'm going to have an electric field, I need to define its vector direction. Let's do an example where I have the electric field in the x direction. This is the z direction. This is the y direction. So here's x, y, z. Let's figure out which direction the magnetic field is in. So we're going to take the electric field in this direction, my direction of propagation this way. The magnetic field would have been in the y direction. So I would have had an hy term. Here's the other thing that's going to tell us about their relative magnitudes. E cross h divided by this function we're going to call eta. Eta is gamma divided by omega mu. And so we can say that the magnetic field is equal to E divided by eta. And the only difference, the magnitude of this magnetic field and the magnitude of this electric field. So if I wanted to write this for an X polarized electric field, I would end up with a y-polarized magnetic field, hy plus of z plus hy minus of z. That's going to be the same thing as E, let's take the magnitude of Ex plus of z divided by eta plus Ex, let's take its magnitude, of z, this is the negative one, also divided by eta.